After a very long time, I am back with another very interesting tutorial for DaVinci Resolve 18.6, whether you have the free or paid version. In this video, I am excited to share how you can create smooth animated gradient background and the text animation inside of DaVinci Resolve without using any third-party plugins. I will guide you through each and every step from start to finish. I am Vikas Kumar from Skyline Motions and I'm happy to have you here. Without any further ado, let's jump right into it by starting a new project. Alright, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve 18.6 and all you have to do the basic setting first. So click on the setting button in the corner and set the size of this project 1920 by 1080, which is a full HD resolution. You can create this animation in 4K as well. You can select the 4K preset from here. And now let's select a frame rate. So in this case, I'm using 60 frames per second for a smooth animation. Once it's done, click on save. And now let's start by creating this animation inside of the fusion page. So we have to take a new fusion composition first. So just go to the media pool, right click on that, click on new fusion composition. And this is going to be the first slide. So I'm going to call it slide 01. Duration, make it 5 seconds long, frame rate 60, click on create. Once it's done, let's drag and drop the slide 01 to the timeline. And then just go to the fusion page. And here we have the media out node, so let's drag and drop the media out to the side for now. And here we have two different viewers, so click on the single viewer and make it single. You can close the media pool if you want. Let's start by taking a fast noise node, so hit Control plus a spacebar for search box and search for fast noise. And this is the fast noise node, hit add button. Let's drag and drop the fast noise to the viewer. Now let's do some basic setting with this fast noise. So just go to the inspector window and here we have the color tab. Just go to the color and this is the alpha. Let's set the alpha value 1 and then just go to the noise and let's do some setting. So this is the detail. So set the detail value 2, contrast something around 1, brightness. Let's down the brightness, set the value negative 0.3. And this is the scale. I'm gonna uncheck this XY. And here we have the X scale and the Y scale. So I'm going to set the X scale value something around 10 and Y scale, let's set the value 1.2 maybe. Perfect. And this is the angle. I'm going to set the value negative 30 degree. And here we have the seeth. So we have to animate the seeth value to get this type of result. So just right click on seeth, click on expression. And I'm going to use a time expression to animate this. So I'm going to set the value time multiply by 0.005. Perfect. Now this is the animated background as you can see. And after that we have to animate the brightness of this fast noise. So just go to the frame number 60, which is equal to 1 second. Right click on brightness, click on animate and go to very first frame of this animation. Set the brightness value negative 1.3 maybe. Perfect. And now we will get this type of result and do the same thing at the end of this animation. So just go to the frame number 240, right click on brightness and lock the brightness value as it is. Go to the end of this animation and let's set the brightness negative 1.3. Perfect. And then we have to attach a color corrector node with the fast noise. So select the fast noise, add a color corrector node, drag and drop the color corrector to the viewer. And inside of the inspector window here, we have the contrast. Let's set the contrast value 1.4 and leave the gain as it is. This is the lift. Let's down the lift value and set the lift value something around negative 0.2. And then we have to select a color for the background. So I'm gonna select this color, I think. Here we have the tint value. You can put the specific tint value, negative 0.52. And now let's create a matte for this color. So what we have to do, this is the background. Let's drag and drop the background on the flow window. Attach a rectangle with it. So this is the rectangle. Let's drag and drop the rectangle. Connect the rectangle with the background and you can see here, this is the background. After that, I'm gonna place this output inside of this black background. So let's take a new merge node. And inside of the merge node, we have four different points. The yellow point is for background, green is for foreground. So I'm going to connect the yellow background point with this background one and green foreground point with this color corrector one, and drag and drop the merge one to the viewer. Select the merge one, go to the inspector window and change this operator over to in, and place this output inside of this rectangle. After that, we have to do some setting with the rectangle. So select the rectangle one, and here we have to do some setting. This is the width and height. So I'm going to set the width value something around 0.32, height value 0.88. Perfect. Now let's change the angle. So I'm going to set the angle value negative 34 degree. Finally, we have to increase the soft edge value. So I'm going to set the value 0.15, I think. And then you can place the rectangle right over here. And you can see here we have this type of animation. Perfect. Now you can place the rectangle something like this. You can put the center X and Y value as well. So this is the center X. I'm going to set the value 0.32 and center Y 0.56. This is the first one. And let's create another copy of this. So what we have to do, select these four nodes, hit Ctrl C to copy, hit Ctrl V over here to paste, and we have to rename these nodes properly. So let's do it quickly. Perfect. Now let's connect the output of this fast noise with this second color corrector. It's very simple. Connect the output of this fast noise with this one, drag and drop the merge 2 to the viewer. Now you can change the color for the second one. So select the color corrector. Here you can switch the color. Perfect. And then you can place the rectangle right over here maybe. And now this is the first one and this is the second one. Let's merge both the outputs. So it's very simple. I'm going to use this as a foreground and this one as a background. So connect the foreground with the background and we will get the new merge. Let's drag and drop the merge to the viewer. Perfect. And after that, we have to attach a black background with this one. So this is the background. Let's drag and drop on the flow window. You can see here we have a black background. I'm going to merge this foreground with this background. So it's very simple. Connect the output of this merge 3 with this background. We will get a new merge. Let's drag and drop the merge to the viewer. And finally, here we have this type of background animation. And now let's attach a text on it. So this is the text tool. Let's drag and drop on the flow window. Connect the output of this text with this merge just like that. And we will get a new merge. Let's drag and drop to the viewer. Select the text and type over here whatever you like. And select your favorite font style. So in this case, I'm using Bebas New Pro font style. You can select any font style that you like. Let's change the style middle. Let's increase the size of the text, something around 0.25. This is the tracking. Let's drown the tracking amount and set the value 0.98. And after that, we have to set the text in the center. So just go to the preview window, right click on that, go to guide and turn on the guide. According to the guide, you can set the text in the center just like that. And then we have to animate the text. So just go to the frame number 90, which is equal to 1.5 seconds. Just right click on size, click on animate, go to very first frame of this animation. Let's down the size just a little bit. So I'm going to set the value 0.15. And now we will get this type of zoom in effect. After that, we have to make this animation smoother. So just go to the spline window, check this option size, hit F4 to full screen, click on fit button, highlight both the keyframes, hit S to smooth, hold the handle and make it a smooth graph. Now you can see the animation. We have smooth, easy in animation. And now you can close the spline window. After that, we have to add one more animation with the text. So select the text, right click on the text box, click on follower modifier, go to the modifier, and here we have the setting. Just go to this setting, and what we have to do, just go to frame number 90, right click on opacity, click on animate and lock the opacity value 1. Go to very first frame of this animation. Let's set the opacity 0 and do the same thing at the end of this animation. So just go to something around 210. Right click on opacity, lock the opacity value as it is. Go to the end of this animation. Let's set the opacity value 0. but we have to create a time gap between each character. So just go to the timing. Let's set the delay value 5, I think. We have to do one more thing. Just go to the order and change this order automatic to completely random. And now we have nice and simple text animation, as you can see. After that, you can do one more thing. Just select the text, go to the tools, go to the end of this animation, and here we have the size. So I'm gonna set the size 0.3, and now we will get this slightly zoom in effect, which is looking nice. And then we have to attach a color corrector node just after this merge 5. So select the merge 5, add a color corrector, drag and drop to the viewer. By using this color corrector, you can switch the color of the background. Perfect. And then we have to connect the media out with this main output. And then you can go to the edit page, and here we have the first slide, which is looking absolutely fantastic. And now let me show you how you can create multiple slides. So select the slide one, hit Control C to copy, place the CTI right over here, hit Control V to paste. Now you can simply edit the slide. So place the CTI on it, go to the fusion page. Here, first of all, we have to change the text. So select the text, type anything that you like. After that, you can change the background color. So select the color corrector 3. And here we have the hue. Let's change the hue value and change the color according to you. All right, and then just go to the edit page, and here we have the first slide and the second slide, and repeat the same process and create multiple slides. And let me show you one more thing. You can add a drop shadow if you want, but this is an optional step. So if you want to add drop shadow, just place the CTI on the slide, go to fusion page, and this is the text. Select the text, hit Control plus a spacebar and search for drop shadow. This is the drop shadow, hit add button. And you can do some setting with the drop shadow. You can set the value 0.2 in the shadow strength, and this is the blur value. Let's leave it 0.55, and here we have the drop distance. And you can set the drop distance something around 0.037, I think so. And this is the drop angle, leave it as it is. Perfect. Now we have a drop shadow on the text, which is looking very nice. And now you can copy the drop shadow effect, go to edit page, go to the second slide, go to fusion page, and here select the text, hit Control V to paste, and now we have the drop shadow on the text. And then go to the edit page, go to very first frame of this animation, and let's have a look. Absolutely amazing, right? And that's a wrap for this tutorial. If you have any questions or thoughts, feel free to drop a comment below. And if you are new to my channel, consider subscribing and giving this video a thumbs up to show your love and support. My name is Vikas Kumar, and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye.